So is healing. Psalm 41:3. The Lord will sustain him upon his sickbed. In his illness, you restore him to health. Good timing, deputy. We need to talk. I give thanks to the Lord every day for bringing you and I together. I'm glad you're looking to do more here. We need you. As you can see, John Seed's making a lot of people suffer right now, and quite frankly, I can't keep up. These people need me. They're my responsibility now. But that just means keeping tabs on the resistance is being that much harder. When you get a chance, head out east and check on our people at the Woodson Pig Farm. I haven't heard back from them in a couple of days, and that worries me. We can't afford to lose a single one of our fighters. End is safe.
Watch my back, will ya? Oh, crap!
Thank you.
fucking play. You fucking see that? We're trapped. We're fucking trapped. I swear to God, I'm gonna kill that son of a bitch, John Seed. You see them Peggy's take off of my plane? I need it back. That was our only chance of getting out. I'd go myself, but my wife's pregnant and due any second, and I just don't know what I'm supposed to do. I mean, without that plane, we're fucked. Please, my family needs your help. I'm sorry. I don't like getting emotional. Name's Nick, by the way. Look, if I know the cult, they've taken my plane to John Seed's ranch. It's got the only other airstrip big enough to land the thing. I know it's a lot to ask, but I'm desperate, partner.
Thank you. Keep on the move!
Dude, just over there!
Sooner or later, that deputy's luck's gonna run out.
You really pulled my fat out of the fire. Thanks.
I've been hearing crazy reports of a massacre at the Garden View Packet Facility. I don't know if the stories are true, but the cult is there, and people need help.
Goodbye now.
Couldn't have done it without you. Cult's making some kind of crazy drug over at the fertilizer plant. I heard that it's really volatile. Someone ought to blow that place to smithereens.
We
could play this game all day. Imagine what we could do with 10 of you.
You
got this. Keep it steady. Okay, I'm gonna have you dip that left wing. That's the one that worries me. It's always acting up a bit. Yep, you'd have gone into a full-on barrel roll by now if something was wrong. Well, guess the cult's got some competent pilots. Stay low here.
my God. Oh, my God, look at her. Son of a bitch, you did it. You did it. Thank you. Jim, the plane's back.
Yeah, I heard.
Hey, come on, let's turn her around. Come on, grab on. You know, this is the first time in a long time I feel like shit's actually going my way. Those damn Peggy's. Jim, come on! Please tell me they didn't fuck with her. You know, this plane's been in my family for 3 generations. Can you believe that? Jim, you coming?
Yeah, I'm coming!
I swear, that woman sometimes. Anyway, my grandpa first got it when he got back from World War II. It was his pride and joy. I made a few modifications over the years. Jim, would you just hurry up? What? Those motherfuckers, they just won't let up. Jesus Christ. Listen, I'm better in the air, but you are a fucking beast on the ground. I'll hit him high, you hit him low. What do you say, partner? Hoorah! Jim, you stay inside till I get back!
Come on. all, Kim. We're leaving.
No.
No?
No.
Come on.
This is our home.
Kim, you just don't understand.
Don't understand what? That they're stealing our land and kidnapping our friends and doing God knows what else?
Kim.
Nick, your grandfather built this place. You really want to turn your back on that? And what about all the times you talked about handing off the business to our daughter?
Oh, I talked about handing off the business to our son.
You've seen the ultrasound. It's a girl.
Well, that was on a messy black and white TV screen. You know them things ain't reliable.
Nick.
I love you.
Me too.
Well, Deputy. Looks like the Rye family's digging in. Hey, listen. If you need any air support, you give me a holler, okay? You and me, you'd be like Butch and Sundance.
Nick, they both died at the end.
Ah.
Please take care of him.
Family's been here since before the town was even founded. Spent a lot of nights drinking with Nick's old man at the Spread Eagle. He's a good kid. Take care of him, Deputy. That family's a symbol of hope for this whole county.
Kim, Nick, I can't stand the notion of sticking my nose where it ain't welcome, but I gotta speak up. I never liked them Eden's Gate people, and I know you never have either. But the time to leave well enough alone may be coming to an end. You got a family to think about, a baby on the way. I know you got a life here and all, but me and mine are gonna leave before this gets ugly. I heard a rumor the law are getting involved, and I don't wanna be here when they do. You have a plane, folks. Pack yourselves in and fly away while you can. Well, that's my piece.
Thank you.
always see the cult and the resistance fighting over the old grain elevator. Both sides want to use it as a supplies cache. I can't use any of that gear, but maybe it's worth a moment of your time. Praise the precious baby Jesus. I can be back in my home.
Can't thank you enough for I heard the cults rounding up wild animals around the old Copperhead rail yard. Why in the world would they do that?
Shut up just in time.
You gotta try this. Best game ever. This is fantastic. There's new stuff added all the time.
You've been putting on some show, Deputy. You got some balls rolling into town like that. Most folk take one look at Eden's Gate and turn the other way. The ones that don't get taught a hard lesson. My dad was one of the first to stand up to him. Anytime the Peggies showed up looking for trouble, Dad would hop in his big rig and chase him out of town. He loved that truck. Called it the Widowmaker. And those fuckers stole it from him a week before he passed. Shit, you really want to piss off the cult? Get the Widowmaker back. Show the cult we're not just gonna roll over. And give the folks here something to cheer about. It's locked up under guard at a grain elevator east of here. But I think you're just the person for the job.
When you consume a creature, the spirit lives on in you.
Thank you. doing all sorts of weird shit.
Thanks, Deputy.
One of the Stricklands saying that they needed to talk to the people at the lookout tower about you know what. Knowing the Stricklands, you know what equals weapons.
Give them hell.
Not letting. Get me out of here. Am I ever? I'd be dead if it weren't for you. We stole some shit from the Peggies and stashed it in the supports of the rail bridge. It's a bitch to get to. But if you got a grappling hook, there's some good stuff waiting for you. I pray every day that this land.
Locked up at the grain elevator. You're sure to run.
love gives me the strength to accomplish anything.
We know what happens next. They come for us. They try to take from us. They try to take our gun.
Come on, we gotta get this truck ready to be stripped.
Ain't that the Widowmaker?
Call it what you want. A truck's a truck, and we need the parts.
It's a symbol of the sinners. We should blow it up.
That's not for us to decide.
You're right. My father knows best.
About time we got this rig off the road. Lost too many of our brothers and sisters to that center.
And we must do even more to break their spirits, brother. These are dangerous people.
I hope there'll be something left to hunt after the collapse.
This side.
Well, welcome in our garden. You just have to say yes. It was the father who said to me.
Help at Falls End that reports the cult found out about the bunker full of guns at the Dover Spike compound. We should head over there, make sure they don't get their hands on them.
Woo-hoo! Yeah! Fuck yeah! Woo-hoo! Yeah! Yeah! Yes! Thank you.
know the sound of that truck anywhere. I gotta say, Deputy, seeing my dad's truck rumbling home sure brings back memories. I'd stand out here every time he came back, just like this, waving him home. You definitely got the grit to handle her, and more importantly, you got the heart. My dad would have liked you. If you ever need to use the Widowmaker, you don't even gotta ask. In the meantime, I'll keep my ear to the ground. If I hear anything that's worth your while, I'll let you know. Thanks again, Deputy.
Pastor Jerome is selfish and misguided. And if he were a true man of God, his people wouldn't have left him in the first place. You, Deputy, will still confess your sins, because this is the will of the Father.
Thought it'd take a my cousin said the cult's taken an interest in the old Wellington mine. I thought that place had dried up. I wonder what they found. Town's free, but the county's still in some trouble.
During my time in the military, I went on a lot of nighttime raids.
a million.
I knew O'Hara before he disappeared. Guy hoarded junk and just had a knack for putting it together. I'd check out his place if I were you. Probably a bunch of useful stuff just sitting there now.
Want to get your mind blown? Try this game.
Deputy, John Seed and his goons nearly siphoned every last drop of our fuel. So before things get... Deputy, John Seed and his goons nearly siphoned every last drop of our fuel. So before things get dire, hijack a couple of Eden's Gate's gas tankers and bring them to Fall's End. It'll slow them down and keep us rolling. Thank you.
chatter about the irrigation system not working. See if you can lend a hand.
This place is what you call a fixer-upper. The cult sure made a mess of this place. The irrigation system's wrecked pretty badly. There are pieces of pipe scattered all over this place. I found most of them. I think there's three missing still. Find them and stick them back where they belong. Then, Sunrise Farm will be good as new.
You never can have enough ammo. Local gal's been bothering the Cougars, asking if we can retrieve some personal items that the cult took from her. We can't really spare anyone right now, but if you're out her way, maybe you could check in on her.
Would not want to run into wolves right now.
Night does have its advantages.
Estimated 19,000 attendees. Tickets are $5.
Pastor Jerome sure saved your bacon.
Laying down one night.
bought a lot of new friends because of what you did in Fall's End. As soon as you and Hudson showed up here, I knew y'all were the type to save us from this bullshit. I heard you saved Fall's End. And I wanted to say thank you.
Thank you. Rebels used when they attacked Nick and me. It's lethal. Knock out everyone you see. My suggestion? Use Nick's plane. He won't mind.
Putting it. You with Casey? Come here, quick. One of these damn vultures gobbled up the key to my barn. Look, it's a long story. Let's just say I was, indisposed. You gotta help me. I'm a lousy shot when it comes to moving targets. Shoot down those vultures. One of them has to have the key.
Thank you. fucked up by animals. Stay out of the north. I'll lie down and die. Only a...
you interested in the truth. Ah, fellow seeker of justice. Yeah, I know who you are. You're that deputy that's been stirring the Peggy's globalist pot. Everything about this cult stinks, and you know I'm right. Say it at the same time as me. Go, we are slaves to the government. Good enough. Mind control. That's right, partner. It's been their plan all along. You know it. I know it. And you want to know how they're doing it? It's the food. Well, not anymore. You and me are gonna fuck the government. Sideways. Name Zip Kupka. I'll explain on the way. Come on. Get in. I'll drive. Not coming to an end like the cult says. That's a demonically driven government ploy of a scare tactic to pull our attention away from what's really happening. This place is ground zero for government fuckery. Baby farms, chemtrails, weather manipulation, pesticides, genetically modified this, that, and the other. I did some digging around the stockyard of the place. Found barrels full of that brain melting stuff. You know what I'm talking about. Bliss. They're feeding it to the animals and we're eating. Chemicals of conformity. And what we need to do is destroy the tools that are indoctrinating us.
There they are, Dip.
Oh, sweet little angels. It's for the best. Sweet little angels. It's for the best.
Trap the place. Their reinforcements will be met with the fire of God. Any demons come back here, they'll be blown sky high. These should do it. They can forget harming innocent, defenseless animals. Never again. Here they come. Wait, what? No, no! They're bringing in cows! Ryan? Davey? Sheena? No! Turn back cows! Don't come in here! This wasn't supposed to happen! You bastard!
for liberty be so high.
Deputy, you've had your fun. But all sinners must confess, this is the will of the Father. My men are coming for you. I'll see you soon.
John is fucking determined to sink his hooks into you, Deputy. Now, I know you got out by the skin of your teeth last time, but don't underestimate this bastard. Dutch out.
They put up a good fight.
Wake up, man.
Be easier just to put a bullet in.
Yeah, that is not the will of the Father. Take them to John. He's ready to hear their confession.
My parents were the first ones to teach me about the power of yes. One night, they took me into the kitchen and they threw me on the ground. And I experienced pain after pain after pain after pain. And when I didn't think I could take any more, something broke free inside. I wasn't scared. I was clear. I looked up at them. I started to laugh. All I could say was, yes. I spent my entire life looking for more things to say yes to. Opened every hole in my body, and when those were filled, I created more. But it was Joseph who showed me just how selfish I was being. Always receiving, always taking. The best gift isn't the one you get, it's the one you give. Courage to own your sin, to etch it onto your flesh and carry its burden. And when you have endured, when you have truly begun to atone, to cut it out like a cancer and display it for all to see. My God, that's courage. I'm going to teach you courage. Teach you how to say yes, so you can confront your weaknesses, confront your sins. You will swim across an ocean of pain and emerge free. for only then can you truly begin to atone. So who wants to go first?
Yes. Yes!
You're not gonna regret this. I promise. Now, before we begin, I think it's only proper that Deputy Hudson goes back to her room. Confessions are meant to be private, after all. I am not here to take your life. I'm here to give it to you. I'm going to open you and pour your worst fears inside. And as you choke, your sins will reveal themselves. And only then will you truly understand the power of yes. I'll be right back.
I want to thank John for purging me of my sins. I understand now that my sins have gotten in the way of me being the man I want to be. I thank you for choosing, and I want to...
I will help you to escape that burden. And that.
When the collapse comes, these folks will thank us.
We're done with that.
Give them all the wrath they can handle, brothers. Say yes. I will give my life in the name of the Father. Center from this place. Let them run. Let them hide. For no matter where they go, God will guide us to them. See? That that is the power of yes.
Holy shit, kid. I've been trying to reach you. I heard John nabbed you and I fear the worst. So I'm glad you made it out. Alive. I'm sorry about Hudson. There's not much we can do without John's key. You're gonna have to lure him out. Figure the best way to do that is to burn his whole fucking operation to the ground. So get to work.
Patrol sitting right in its path.
Even the father knows deeply of sin. It's a poison that clouds our mind.
I'm gonna hit the target!
What if I told you could be dreams? What if I told you that everything you ever dreamed? What if I told you that everything could be overcome if you embraced an idea? That freedom from sin. Sinners.
Eyes on target.
Every one of us. You, me. Even the father knows deeply of sin. Cloud our mind. Cleansed. You will confess your sins.
detect predators around here.
Who are they?
Don't think age matters to us whitetails. We need all the help we can get. Take George, for example. He's got to be pushing 80, but he's one of our best spotters. I tell you what, let's go see how he's doing.
Sharky's a damn fool.
Our sin. Greed.
You can taste the motor
oil
in the air.
And we drift down the corridors of consumerism. And we've got our phones and our pads pressed up against our faces. Not stopping, never taking notice of the pain and the suffering of those...
Down there!
behind.